Welcome, welcome everyone. It's time for more Starfield, where last time we left the moon and went to Earth and NASA. And we went to the exhibit, checked that out, but then delved further into the sort of underground complex. And we found this thing. This is where they tested the first grav drives, I think. Or is it where they tested the first grav drives? I'm a little bit unsure exactly where the first tests were, but we learned a lot about the initial grav drive tests. Apparently someone found an artifact on Mars, which is a bit exciting. So they took it to, I suppose, Earth first, but then the moon, tested it out on the moon, and that is what caused the Earth to basically go bananas. And yeah, they basically doomed Earth, but instead we got the grav drives, which basically made us able to colonize the galaxy. So was it a good payoff? I don't know, but it is what happened. And now the starboard are here, apparently. We got a artifact from in there, sort of the original artifact, I suppose. And yeah, I mean, when we were talking about anti-gravity and grav drives, etc., etc., the artifacts... There we go, parents have gotten their money, lovely. Yeah, when we find artifacts, we do find them in sort of anti-gravitational fields. So that sort of checks out. Kind of almost forgotten about that. But anyway, the Starborn are here. I see some green stuff. Is that someone who's trying to target something? Slightly unsure, but the Starborn are here, and we're gonna have to deal with them getting out. Kind of almost felt like the Hunter and the Emissary set me up, almost. Not gonna lie, kind of felt like it. I am also severely over-encumbered. I am at 294 out of 140. There has been so much stuff in here. But I'm okay, I hope. I was sort of vaguely planning on getting out of here between episodes, but indeed, the Starborn showed up. Now, I have an idea. Oh, bloody... Ow! Why did I not run? Okay, well, that was stupid. Now I have a bad leg. Now we need to fix that. Jesus. Why did I jump like that? Oops. Do I have anything to treat this? I've used a... fair whack of these, but I am also picking them up all over the place. But do I have something for broken stuff? I had the panacea, but that's like super good, so I don't want to use that unnecessarily. And I can survive with a broken leg. I do not have anything for broken limbs. Gotta be honest, that's a bit of a bummer. Yeah, I don't think I have any. Well, isn't that a bit of a bother? Okay, I'm not going to use the super heal, so we're just going to have to live with a broken leg or whatever it is that I got. Lovely. I think if we check this, yeah, absolutely, we're going upwards. That seemed reasonable. And I do have a boost pack. Don't forget boost pack. I can literally, like, just boost up here. There we go. Lovely. Use my power. And now, run! There we go. Much better. Jesus. Now, let's see how squishy the Starborn are nowadays. Can see one over there. Now, are you in the way? Oh, of course you are. What are you doing? So we have two of them even. You're a bit weird looking, aren't you? Okay, so I have the ability. Oh. Doing something. Okay, you are tough, not gonna lie, but you go down. I'm still hidden. That's good, but where did the other one go? Because there is absolutely one more. Now, I do wonder, by the way, we know from previous episodes that when you collect all the artifacts, you combine it to be able to go see the Unity, which apparently is a thing, and the Unity will allow you to become a Starborn. Now I'm wondering, at what point in that process do you become such as they are, which is that when you die, you just evaporate. When does that happen? I'm very curious. Where the hell did the other one go? Don't wish to fight unnecessarily. Did you like... Did he just disappear? Did he just teleport out or something? I mean, I'm okay with that, but it's weird. But alright then, if no one else wants to... Oh, bloody hell. Yeah. Get all the stuff back. I don't see anyone right here, so I'm taking a chance. Anyone up here? No, but I do have some. I did see some orange. Oh yeah. Someone's here. All right. Yeah, hello. Starborn, shot in the face. Okay, you are a bit trickier or tougher than I anticipated. That's true. How did that miss?
Thank you for eluding me even for a moment.
Okay. Oh. Oh, hello. Yep.
Our side in this little game.
You are taking this like a champ in orange. Ow, you shot something that spiked me. You know what? There we go. Ow. There we go. Quantum essence I get from this, apparently. Well, that's lovely. And yeah, something bad happened to me right then and there. You shot me with something. I have some orange stuff. We're gonna have to get rid of that, but that's all a-okay for now. Hopefully. Still have a broken limb. You took a lot of damage. I mean, this gun does good damage, I think. Well, actually, you know what? I want to check one thing. You do 70 damage. We did pick up something. The Instigator Refined Old Earth Hunting Rifle. Why don't we try that out for now? It doesn't have any mods or anything, so it's very basic. But it packs a punch almost twice as much, which is kind of nice. And I am also becoming better and better at like rifles and stuff like that, so yeah. Don't have any recon sight or anything like that, remember that, but should hopefully be fine still. Okay, let's... Oh! Someone noticed that a little bit. I think I saw something over there. Yeah. Potentially. Oh! Oh? I don't know, but something was going on. Is this where I can go? Game? Why? Oh, right now, I was about to say, what the hell are you saying? Oh, have I been here? I mean, I have been here, that's absolutely true. This is where we came down, but... Okay. Sure. Oh, right there. That's where you are. I missed. Good job. I missed again. Good job again. Oh, hello. There we go. Okay, this gun I like. More quantum essence. Is that where we get quantum essence from then? That's lovely. I think we are... Bunch of these things. I have power cells, so that's okay. Everything powered on. Yeah, thought all of this was already on before, but apparently not, but that's okay. So now, flip switch, stuff up. We're obviously going upwards. Yes, why would I go down? That would not have made sense. Okay, is this... This is the final bit, isn't it? I think it is. Or... Yeah. Of course, bloody hell. It's not been that long, but I have still forgotten most about this. This is just a door. Ow, crap. I do have the maintenance key. That's A-alright. Yeah, this gun. We're gonna boost this gun. Yeah, that's all powered up. That's lovely. Not seeing much. Okay, a little bit on the thing. That's a maintenance key to get in here. Don't think I've been in here. So it's just, well, would you believe it? It's more stuff. Like, I need more stuff, but it is free stuff, and I do enjoy free stuff, like all of these things that I'm picking up. I have not produced a whole lot of those myself. Let me just tell you what. I have been picking up most of them. That's okay, my book. Absolutely. For now, just a quick run as we have the power active. Okay. Does it feel like I've been here? Because that's an emergency exit. That's an emergency exit. Oh, hold on. Emergency cuttable wall, but we can also go through here. Okay, never mind. I understand why that did not make sense, because I literally haven't had to use it. There's gonna be someone here, right? That's something? No. Nothing. Okay, someone thought they heard something. So where am I now, really? Like, it doesn't feel like I remember this. It wasn't that long ago since I did last, since I recorded last episode. Oh, I see someone there. Yeah. Or down there somehow. So if I would just go up here. There we go. There you are. Well, that was pointless. That was pointless. I can get you from here, though. Home steady. Ooh, nice. One hit kill. I kind of like this gun. We're gonna mod it a bit to make it better. But where are you up there? Potentially, yes. That's a thing about the thingamabobs. That is to say, the but he is where we are supposed to be. Where am I going? Get out of here. Is it up? Yes. Okay, you want me to go up at least. So, use power. You must be right here, right? Okay, no. Where do you want me to go? Well, we're supposed to go up, I think. So, if I just... That's a-okay. Can go around here, I think. Yep, this seems the right way. Did I check this? Not really, I think. So, a bunch of stuff here. More stuff. what is this? Starter calibrated deep recon space helmet. Slightly better stats there. Melee damage, so that's fine. I'll leave that be. I think what I have is still a little bit better than that. So we have at least one more before we get out. It's going to be through this door. Balls. I'm loving it with the balls lately. They are a pair of bloody balls or something. Alright. Yeah, this gun. Holy hell, with the sneak damage. Obviously. So much bonus damage. Very lovely. Okay, so now we are... Yeah, this is where we have the first computer, I want to say. But no, it's not, is it? Yeah, it's like I haven't been here almost. It's like I haven't been here. 60... How far down did I go? How bloody far down did I go? Okay. Well, it's a good thing. When I use the power, you get the orange bit on the... stealth meter, and if you don't get it, it means that there's no one close by. So that's a good thing. Yeah, we seem to be okay here. Again, I mean, I had a slightly slow episode last episode because, you know, there were like one robot and a few turrets and that was it. A bit more action this time around, but it's still a bit slow. But that, you only just have to live with that. And let's just use it. Yeah, no one's bothering. Or is being bothered by that. Oh, there must be someone here, right? Surely. Doesn't actually look like it. No? Seem to be fine. This is where the first computer is, wasn't it? Yeah, that one. Or, well, say first, but one of the first. So this is... Hey. What is this? Where am I? Oh, no, I'm apparently not going here. Ah, right, there it is. There's the elevator. All right, then. We made it out successfully, at least so far. The hunter and the emissary wants to chat to us about us finding that artifact. I don't exactly know what they want, but let's make it to the surface at least and see if they greet me or if I have to go to the ship. Well, nothing immediately, but the mission updated to talk to the emissaries. Maybe the hunter doesn't actually want to chat with us anyway. Okay, well, you know what? They're both down there. Just, I would love to just... It's so lovely. But I'm actually quite far away, so maybe that wouldn't help that much. Now, what's the best way down? What's the best way down? Down here. I'm vaguely thinking that there aren't going to be any Starborn here, because that kind of feels weird if there was. So let's just slide out. There we go. Lovely, we made it out. Happy times. And there's their ship. Ships, plural this time around. Hello.
Do you understand now why I asked you to come here? The artifacts unlock the secret of interstellar travel. At the cost of Earth.
An easy trade, honestly. Why have one world when you can have all the settled systems?
I mean, yes, I'm a bit divided on this one, because... we lost our home. Yeah, sure. But at this point in time, we're talking the 21... What was it? The 2120s or 30s or something like that? Or was it 2140? Anyway, about 100 plus years from now, surely the planet would have been really badly off by then. It's quite badly off right now, but like at that point in time, wouldn't it be even worse off? I don't know. I don't know really. But anyway, what I wanted to say about that is that, sacrificing Earth for this. I mean, okay, fine. In the manner of how they did it, maybe not that good. Like, not telling people and blaming it on something else. But still. And indeed, this is a good point. Humanity's destiny was the stars anyway. Yeah, it kind of always has been. So, well, in some ways, I suppose. Okay, I'm going to go with that one. As a matter of fact, I'm gonna side with the hunter for the most part. Me and the hunter, we can probably get along.
Don't you see? The power of the artifact forced humanity to the stars. They didn't get to make a choice. How many would have chosen Earth? And what gave Victor Eiser the right to choose for them?
You see the hypocrisy in what the emissary is saying, right? They don't want to rob people of their free will, but then they steal the artifacts for themselves.
In the wrong hands, the power of the artifacts can make anyone a tyrant. That's why we watch over them. The only thing you're watching out for is yourself.
But on the other hand, the hunter is not a tyrant. He's doing it solely for his own sake. And, well, I still have questions about that, because, again, why? Well, okay, fine. In some ways, I do know why. He's saying that if you gather, like, enough power... You can sort of somehow, I don't know exactly how, but see the sort of creation of the universe in some way, and he kind of wants that. But, I mean, that doesn't make him a tyrant. It only makes him a person with a purpose, in some ways. Alright, emissaries are right, artifact needs to be right hands. I mean, I'm okay with that, just not your hands. The hunter is right, the only real rule is who gets all the artifacts. First, or you're both wrong. It is time for someone other than a Starborn made a decision. Yeah, here we go. But it kind of also begs the question. I mean, okay, I did have one potential spoiler spoiled for me, so to speak, by the game, in where I thought that I might have been a Starborn. But now, when we know how the Starborn are made, that does not follow. No, but I am special. The Hunter has said that I am special because I normally apparently die in every single universe, but I haven't died in this one. I've actually made it quite far. So that means that I'm special, and then it means that I'm gonna be the one to deal with all of this.
Don't be a fool. The Emissary and I may have our differences, but you do not want to give us a common enemy.
For once, he's right. Don't do this. We can collect the final pieces together.
Nah, not really interested in that. But on the other hand, okay. I do wonder what the most fun is. I'm gonna assume that the Hunter is the most fun, right? Surely. But I kind of do want to go against it. But again, on the other hand, I mean, here's the thing. This is the first time I play this game. I want to see content, damn it. And if I go for this, which absolutely could be a case for like a second playthrough, it feels like I'm going to miss out on stuff, doesn't it? And I don't want to miss out on stuff unnecessarily just because. So, you know what? As I had, as I've already said, that the Hunter seems to be a little bit more to my liking. Yeah, Hunter, how about we high five and, you know what, kill the Emissary.
Yes, I also like picking winners.
Fine. You two have made your choice. The usual place?
The buried temple. Oh yes, we'll be there.
I'm sorry it's come to this.
Okay.
You and I better have a chat. Talk through the next steps. I have a little favor I want to ask you, too. Besides, there's no point going to the buried temple until all the other artifacts have been gathered. Your friends in Constellation should be able to help you there. They always seem to have a knack for finding the stragglers.
But let's talk about stuff. What about the buried temple? What is that?
That was a little playground where Starborn liked to fight over the last artifact before going to the Unity. You like it? It's got everything.
Ooh, I like how you emphasized on the everything. So what you're saying is that pick up all the artifacts that are left, then go to Buried Temple where you have a sort of, it almost sounded now like you have a, what would it be? Oh, why did I lose the word now? Ceremonial, there we go, like a ceremonial final battle, and whoever wins, wins, but it doesn't really also make sense. I assume you wouldn't fight to the death, necessarily. So, alright then. Yeah. What is the point about not going there right away?
It'd be pointless. The last artifact is always temperamental. It's like it wants all of its siblings in one place before it'll show up. We need to bring all the others to it. I'll have mine, the Emissary will have theirs. That just leaves you and Constellation to find the rest.
But okay, but that doesn't... Wait, what do you mean? You have yours, the Emissary have theirs, and we need to find more. Why couldn't you find the remaining ones? Have you found enough, now you're satisfied, and then it's all the big showdown. That's okay, yeah, as I said, it kind of feels like a ceremony. You go to each universe, you pick up the same artifacts, and then you just sit around and wait or something? I don't understand that one. So, alright then, why are we not attacking the Emissary right now, taking their artifacts for ourselves?
No, this is how it works. Trust me, I've tried this a bunch of ways. The Emissary will wait at the buried temple for us. Gives you a little time to prepare before the final throwdown. And for our part, we wait to kill them until we get there. I mean, maybe the Emissary will kill us instead, but I like our odds.
But again, if you always fight the death, how is there always a new Emissary? Because the Emissary needs to be Starborn, but if you always pick the artifacts, no one else becomes a Starborn, right? Bethesda, I'm not 100% sure you've thought this through. Either that, or I don't understand, but I currently don't necessarily understand this. Anyway, you want to join me?
Oh, I'm not missing this. I'll be meeting you there.
But okay, what is that favor then?
Keeper Aquilus. My illustrious counterpart. He's a loose end that needs tying.
But why? You're gonna pick up all the artifacts and then you're out of here. Why do you care about him?
First, he led you to my meeting with the emissary. Now, that's turned out well for me, but it's hardly good to have someone who knows your secrets hanging around. Second, I don't like him. You'll understand once you've been through a few times. Other versions of yourself have a habit of being distasteful.
Well, that's a bit curious. Okay. I mean, yeah, again, killing him, what would that actually give us? Like, how is he a problem?
On the contrary, it cements my trust in you. Sorry to be pushy in the beginning of our partnership, but I insist. Let me take in this moment. It's not every day you get to send an assassin after yourself. Good luck.
Well, alright then, fine. We'll see what I do about that. We do have another level up. That's lovely. So, kill or ward, it did say, right? So, we are going to be able to get a choice here. So, main... complete final glimpses. Didn't I do that? Oh, in order to do that, we need to do this. Okay, interesting. I need to gather any remaining artifacts, and that is apparently what we do here. But didn't I just get... Yeah, here we go. Okay, so that just became... I don't know, a misc one. So kill or war. None wants me to kill Keeper Aquilus, his other self from another universe. Sure. As I've said, I want to keep doing the main story as much as possible. So we're going to go back to the lodge. We're going to chat with people, presumably talk a little bit about what's been going on, what I have been doing on the moon and Earth. And we shall see where we go from there. Now, where the hell is my ship? All the way over there. Lovely. Let me get back to the lodge, and I might nip by... I want to nip by my base, but I'm not 100% sure I need it. I can just dump the stuff that I have, like the resources, in my ship for now. Alright then, we are back. We have all our friends gathered. That's very lovely. Let's see what they make of what I have found, huh? Hello, guys. You're all waiting for me.
Mateo told us about your pilgrim's voyage.
You found it, didn't you? The meaning of unity.
Oh, I sure did. The center of the multiverse. We're building a way to it. I suppose we could be open about it. Infinite number of me out there. I feel sorry for all of them. Bert is a live version of him from another universe. No. Let's stick to the point here about unity.
Wait, say that again. Multiple universes?
You can't possibly mean what I think you mean.
Yes, I wouldn't mind a little more detail.
Well, I met a version of Barrett. He told me the Unity creates the Starborn, and they can cross universes. That is, you know, the truth, or the to-the-point, so to speak, thing. Apparently in another universe I died and Barrett lived. He's the emissary. Now, I mean, we're going way too fast and we're talking about that. Trust me, there's multiple universes. The Unity is how we get to them. It makes you Starborn. Again, way too quick. I have met a version of Barrett, and that is how we know about the Unity and how that creates Starborn. And these people can traverse universes.
I don't even want to think about the physiological changes you'd need to travel between universes.
Plus what it would do to the mind? Enlightenment? Or oblivion? Like the Hunter.
You have the opportunity to reach the closest thing to your god that might exist. And you're second-guessing it?
One doesn't approach the afterlife without some trepidation.
I mean, that's true. But we have our mission to go into the unknown. That's true. Think of what awaits us, a new life, the powers of the Starborn.
You okay?
Well, for the love of God, you're very quick this time. We should all take time to think about what this means. That's a good response, yes.
You're right. This is a lot to take in.
Not to make a sharp turn in a grand tale, but I got the eye fixed up. Bruised, but still blinking. Let me know when you're ready to follow up on what it's seen.
Well, I am very ready about that. Ready for that, I mean. So, let's talk about it immediately.
These last glimpses from the eye are from the farthest fringes of known space. Could be the only remaining pieces outside the hands of the Starborn.
Alright, good. So, yeah. When do you remember when deep space, indeed, was our only problem? Ah, to be young and naive.
Aye. The blackest sea seems less of a concern when there are sharks leaping out at you.
That is true. But absolutely, I'll follow up on the artifacts.
Catch a smile out there.
I like how he says that. So Freya and Seti, I think that's how you pronounce that. So all right then, while we're here, why don't we chat a little bit with
At this
people?
Point, I don't care what you have to do to get that project back on track. Within reason.
Sure.
I'm expecting big things from you with this ship project. Don't let me down.
You're really into that thing, but what about the Unity?
Counter to everything I've said and believed before. I've caught myself wondering if we ever should have started this search. If this is all true, and I have it right, we've potentially started a chain of events that will create more of these Starborn. Or worse, enable the ones we've seen to become even stronger. I am not fond of either of those options. So maybe now we have no choice but to finish this journey. Before one of them does.
I mean, that is an interesting point, actually. Which is that, had we not, or we as a Constellation, had Constellation not initiated the search for the artifacts, would the Hunter and the Emissary have been able to even find them? Is that like a prerequisite in all universes, that Constellation starts the exploration and the trying to find the artifacts? That's an interesting point. Right then, we don't know for sure what will happen. We can stop now. Reach Unity first. We can level the playing field. Yes, there we go. There's the power move.
Does it even work like that? This is enough to make your head spin. Look, I don't like the idea of siding with either one of these groups. I'd much rather see someone from Constellation get there first. I trust any of us far more than these Starborn.
Oh, trust me, I am Goodbye. Taking the Hunter out as quickly as I humanly can when the opportunity arises. Alright then, Mateo, what do you think about this?
Feel free to help yourself at the bar. I don't drink, but I feel like if I did, now would be a good time for one.
Well, you're not wrong. So yeah, what about the Unity? What's your take on it?
I thought I had a grip on the situation. I'm not so sure anymore. The Sanctum Universum believes that God wanted us to travel the stars. That's gotten us here. Is this... Could this be the next step in that journey? Is this what we were meant to learn out here? Could the Unity... Could that be God? Or a way to reach him?
I wouldn't count on it, but yeah, I'll let you know when I get there, you know.
Oh yeah? That would be something, no question. The one thing I'm sure of is that we have to see this through. We need to find the rest of the artifacts.
Well, we're on it, don't
worry. Take care of yourself.
And then just that cheery, cheery old goodbye. And where did you go, the lady? Name I've apparently forgotten. Where did you go? You naffed off somewhere. Well, I wanted to chat with you, but now I don't know where you are. And you don't come up on the compass either, so that is not gonna help. Yeah, no. Not 100% sure where she is. She might have gone to bed or something, but I don't even know where her bed is. Can't see her. Would have loved to just get her point in on this too. But she is nowhere to be seen, actually. Well, she might be downstairs then. Could she have gotten around? Do they go down here? Ah, there we go. My fractured limb cured. How the hell did that happen? I don't know, because I've been running around on it. But all right then. Yeah, she's not here either. Oh, bloody hell, that almost gave me a fright. A master lock, you say? Well, we're gonna leave that be for now. Anyway, with all that said and done, I was about to say I want to go and buy some aid for my broken limb, but now we don't need to, so that's good. So, alright. As we are here, why don't I go and chat with Keeper Aquilus, see what we can do about him. I don't know if I want to kill him, not necessarily, but we'll go and have a chat with him, see what he thinks about the situation. Alright, we are back inside this place. I was about to say he's alone, but no.
I'm happy to help out in whatever way I can here. Anything Thomas needs, I'm here for him.
You're here, which is slightly annoying. You're actually... Hold on.
So many mysteries in the universe. Why? So many unknowns.
Thomas, why are you sitting in this chair?
I try to help out others whenever I get the chance.
Alright, well, let's chat with you.
Did you find it? Your answers? I haven't had a chance to talk about all the truths of Unity in quite some time.
Well, we kind of know what the Unity is now. You're a Stormborn and you're the Hunter. That's... When I said that and he gave me that smile, that was weird. I was expecting to find something spiritual, not a multiverse. I think I can understand the lesson you wanted to teach me, Keeper. I don't know if that's true. I don't know if that's true, but I'm actually going to go for that one. And the reason why I say that is because I'm not 100% sure what the lesson is.
Oh? And what lesson would that be, I wonder?
Well, you tell me. So there's more to life than the hunt for the artifacts. That's true. The hunt for the artifacts is just a means to an end. The hunt of the emissary, you, they're all perspectives. I mean, he doesn't even know about this. Why would I drop that on him? They're all perspectives, like the sanctum.
If you have questions, I'm happy to try and answer.
Yes, yes, yes.
But you do have to actually ask first.
If you want to look wise, never answer a direct question. But, yeah, you know what, I'm going to say this, the Hunter, the Emissary, you, etc., all different perspectives, even though he doesn't know what the hell I'm talking about, but it is true.
Ah, an interesting theory. When you cross into a new universe, what do you really bring with you? Your beliefs, for one. Anyway, if you do get to the Unity... I hope you keep our conversations in mind. Figure out your own truth and hold on to it. It could end up being the only constant you have amidst the infinite worlds that will stretch out before you.
Now hold on. How did you know anything about this? Because that didn't seem like a surprise to you. Hold on. Okay. Wait. Hold on. Are you a Starborn? Hold on. How many universes have you been to?
That's actually a difficult question to answer. There was a time when I just stopped counting. I didn't care anymore. Only touching the infinite again mattered. But as my need for answers deepened, my pace slowed. I began to take in more. Sometimes I would try to share my experiences with others. It was a long time until I realized this is where I belonged, in this universe, building the sanctum.
Oh, well, That kind of now makes a bit more of sense that the Hunter would love to kill you, because you're literally a Starborn and you've been to countless universes yourself, basically doing exactly the same.
Was there something more on your mind?
As the current Hunter is doing, but the difference between you and him is that you stopped. Okay. Yeah, so you know what the Unity is, so how does the Sanctum's view of Unity, you know, correlate?
Which one is the actual Unity, the concept, or the nexus between universes? The fact that a real center point between us all exists makes me believe more strongly that something greater is out there.
Something greater than that, huh? And also, by the way, Thomas here, he's just, what the F are they talking about? But all right, then let's get to the meat here. I've met the hunter, or, you know, you, and he wants me to kill you.
Of course, how could he not? It's exactly what I would do if I was still as lost as he is. You are never fully separate from your other selves, not completely. Do we somehow share a soul, and is it merely our actions that differ? Huh. Another Vermilion questions to ponder.
I mean, that is an interesting thing, as a matter of fact. That, yeah, in a multiverse setting, you would arguably have... But the point... There is one obvious issue in some ways with... with a multiverse setting, which I don't think any multiverse setting has ever been able to completely explain, which is that clearly events unfold differently. I mean, the Hunters has said as much. We almost always die in each universe, but we survived in this one. So clearly in the multiverses, things happen differently.
So much to ponder. Just
chill out.
Sometimes it's difficult to know where to start.
And the point about that is that when did it start? When did the changes start? Because as soon as you have one change, that change ripples. So how is it that I exist in each and every multiverse, even? Like, how did everything just come down to me existing if we've been doing random events for 13.4 billion years, or whatever it is? Yeah, it doesn't really make sense that we would right here, right now, be in the exact same place as as we would otherwise. Or, yeah, it doesn't really make sense, and it's the same with, like, let's say, the Marvel multiverse, basically. Everyone exists at the same point in time, but just in different multiverses. So yes, we're gonna try to persuade you. Why don't you try and leave and go where the hunter can't find you, so I don't have to kill you.
And leave you to join my counterpart to enter the Unity? Are you prepared to take that step into the infinite? What kind of person is heading through there?
Well, Thomas has had it, so he's a bit tricky. Oh, do I not have an auto-persuade? Did I use one? I might have used one, yeah. So, alright, for +2, you believe Unity is more than something to be fought over. I can't let that idea die with you. That's true, and that's what he believes, I think. As a conviction keeper, if you believed in your cause, you would take this chance to live. Now I'm gonna go with the +2 here.
I appreciate that.
Yeah, I kind of figured. So I have some faith, I've come so far, I've had enough of you trying to teach me lessons. Just run! Have some conviction, that's the same. I learned from Sanctum Universe and that we can't abandon a search for greater truth. I mean, that's true, let's try it.
Yes, jumping through universes can make things seem wondrous and complex, but there remains a simplicity that can only be seen as primordial, even divine. I see you did pay attention to our talks. Very well. I'll leave. Thank you for giving me this chance. I'll need to make some arrangements here, and then I'll be gone.
Well, there you go. That worked, and we can apparently go and have a chat with the hunter. Now he's just going to be in, like, his ship somewhere. And where would that be? So right now, apparently in Oborum Prime. Is he on a planet or in a ship? He is. I suspect. Oh, is it on the planet? You have like a base on the planet. Not 100% sure. Alright then, we'll end the episode by going and chatting with the hunter, see what he makes of my little solution. Alright, we arrive here and he is actually just here. Can I just hail you without
boarding. Do we? Here says we can't even hail him. So I assume that that means that we need to board. Yes, okay. Fine, that's absolutely okay. Let's go aboard, have a chat with him. Hello there. You are looking fine, my good sir.
So, how was it? Did you kill Aquilus, as I asked? Or did you let him go?
And presumably, I'm gonna be able to lie. Well, actually, I can't lie. I need to persuade him. Ooh. Well, we're gonna try that.
Are you sure? He isn't, say, hiding somewhere he thinks I won't find him?
No, I'm sure. Ooh. Hello. Manipulation. Afraid he's gonna come back. And here I believe you were beyond that sort of a thing.
You think I wanted him dead out of fear? That's the funniest thing you've ever said. Very well. Funny. Doesn't quite feel the way I was expecting. Well, no matter. Next universe, I'll handle it myself. See if that makes a difference.
But okay, oh, I got something. The Last Priest, and a whole bunch of credits too. I don't know why you're throwing credits at me, but I enjoy it. But, okay, what you just said was that in the next universe you'll do it yourself, but what's to say in the next universe he's one of the people who's been through a lot of universes? Like, is that always going to be true? Again, I'm not 100% sure that they've thought this through. I don't really think they have. Or again, it could just be me who doesn't understand anything. That's very, very possible too. But alright then. The next step is going to be, indeed, back to Final Glimpses. The game did that for me, thank you. So how far are we going? We are going up... didn't he say like the fringes? But you know what? Actually, Tau Ceti is on the fringe. We also have Van Manin Star. I haven't gone there, apparently. Well, I might have. No, I don't think I've been there, Van Manin Star. I think I have been to Tau Ceti. Yes, I have been to Tau Ceti. So we need to go to this little moon right here, which is a temperate moon. Lovely. But, alright. One thing that's also true is that if we go back to here and to our powers, we still have... now 8 undiscovered temples. I suppose the temple that the hunter was talking about is still out there. Now the question is, am I going for an artifact or a temple now? Intriguing. But alright then, yeah, I have been picking up some quantum essences now, so now I can boost the generation speed of the powers, which is lovely. I've almost forgotten what my powers are. So I had the anti-gravity field, which I didn't really understand how it worked. It didn't feel like it did anything. I had the dash, which is, yeah, like the whirlwind thing from Skyrim. Gravity wave can push people or things. Precognition, bend time, and glimpse the future. Seeing the path someone will walk in the words they may say. I mean, that's a fun one to some degree, but like exactly how useful is it? I'm thinking now about the words they may say thing. Like, how would you use that? It could be interesting to see that, I think. Also, by the way, there we go. Would love to have those on there. But there are absolutely more powers that I would love to find. So if we're looking for temples or artifacts now, I don't know. But we are going to continue with the main story for a while. Feels like I have more stuff to do there. And what I was about to say about the temples is... are all temples that you can find going to come up in the main story? Or are you actually supposed to, you know, go and look for them? Because that might be true. I'm not 100% sure, because like the temples don't follow the same logic as the artifacts. The artifacts we can find from the gravitational fields. But the temples, I don't think, are the same. Well, actually, you know what? No, they are the same, aren't they? Because they also have... sort of anti-gravitational stuff within them. Anyway, you know what? I'm not going to think too much about that, but it is a thought that we might have to do some just exploration on our own to try and find temples, because obviously I haven't been on every single planet. But I'm also slightly worried now, which is that which celestial bodies did we find temples? I'm seeing here Narion, for example. Smarty. Like, I don't remember really. So Nera seems like I remember. But that's one of a kind salvage. Linic is there. Dalvik, whatever that is. See, I don't remember. Podius. I don't remember the names here. I might have to. Crete, sort of. Crete Research Lab. I did recognize it, but no, that was it. Vectera. No, that's where we were. Bloody hell. Don't remember anything. Valo, then I just want to see. Here we go. Polvo. There we go. No, that's Hopetown. For the love of God, I don't know. Anyway, what I was about to say is that where have the temples been so far? Because I think these icons are just... Like, why don't I... Is that... No, but that's where I have bases. That's what that is. That's my bases. This is just places where we can go. So in Wolf, we have the Den. Example, that's the only thing that is. Anyway, never mind, I am rambling a bit here at the end. We are gonna continue with the main story. We're gonna be looking for artifacts and temples. We're gonna get more powers, and I'm gonna hold off on the sort of final encounter as long as I can, presumably, but we shall see how far away that is. For now though, this has been Ghostmutgaming with me, Christopher. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.